Welcome back to Ultimate General Civil War. When it comes to breaking through these defenses, I don't see any weak point except that one in one area over there. So I get the feeling I should probably take all of my brigades and attack there. And that's what I'm gonna do. I'll leave some brigades over here, though. I guess split my army in half, right? Leave some cannon. Just some, not all. Not most of it, though. And I'll attack this point here. There's a gap in their fortifications, so that means that point is weaker than the rest of their line. There's also a gap here, but the problem is that when you push for that, you will encounter a great deal of enemy resistance. I'll leave General Grant here as well. And we'll get started. It seems we're gonna get flanked. It does appear to me that this is their weakest point in their line. Over here on the north side, it's close to impregnable. I mean, nothing is impregnable, you can always win, it's just the amount of units that you'd have to lose to break through would be extremely high. I'm getting to work over here. Gonna drive out these dismounted cavalrymen. And keep shooting Terry. Once he falls, and he will, should be able to advance. Now I need these skirmishers out of the way as well. Those shields themselves will give me some protection as I advance. I could deal with it. Ah, that artillery. Oh man. Alright, reinforcements. We're pouring more infantry into the enemy's defenses. Alright, let's do it. Okay. Huh. That's the point where I'm gonna attack then. I'll send some brigades to keep them occupied. Send more units over here. Reload. Alright, we're making progress over there. Move artillery forward. Taking some damage over here. Move supplies. And break through their lines over here. As best we can. Once once this point is captured, I'll be able to move more brigades. Actually, is there... Interesting, there's no one there, it seems. Meanwhile, the advance continues south. Alright then. Damn, these defenses are formidable. We have a fort. Huh. Okay. Yeah, we should be able to. Alright, let me just save over here, F1. So if it's only dismounted cavalry, we should be able to take it, right? Might be better served to just attack in the south, because clearly the northern part is not gonna fall so easily. They do actually have proper brigades over there. So be it then. Deploy artillery over here. The battle rages on in the trenches. Does it now? We are gonna get reinforcements, I imagine. Doesn't matter. I'm gonna get the cavalry over here. Move the artillery ahead. Resupply my units. There is a clear line to most of their artillery there that I'm going to use with my cavalry. So charge right there. Confederate cavalry has shown its face. Skirmishers have surrendered. Their front line has collapsed. Alright, their fortifications, their outer fortifications at the very least, have broken. Alright, we need more men over here to break through Longstreet's brigades. Sending in more reinforcements, gonna take more units over here. More brigades. Alright, General Sherman is needed at the very front line over here to oversee this situation. I'll dispatch. Alright, we are breaking through. We do have them on the run over there. They need reinforcements. I'm just gonna speed this one up. Alright, they're routing. There, there, and there. Routed. They've lost some 5,000 men. I've lost some 7,000 men. No, actually, they've lost some 10,000 men. Alright, then. And keep in mind, the game doesn't count brigades that have been completely routed, which I haven't had a single brigade completely route. We need more supplies, more artillery, more of everything, really. Throw every shit we have in this. Where's my... Oh, no, you don't, mate. Cavalry should be able to take Beauregard. More supplies. Take the good general out. Alright, the rebel cavalry is defending the fort. Meanwhile, Confederate dismounted. Okay. We do have this position over here. Well, you heard the commands. We either take this fort today or we fucking fall. The issue with taking the fort, though, of course, is that it's actually quite heavily defended. Though there are, what, two units? Thing is, we need to flank them. So a frontal assault is really out of the question over there. Alright, the fort has fallen over here. regroup then. I'll leave the skirmishers to hold it. The rested army will advance. Alright. We must prevail. Alright, we have two of the free trenches, though these troops could possibly use some support, so I'm gonna send an entire brigade over here just in case things go to shite. While continuing my advance. These brigades have done nothing the entire battle except take damage, but they're almost ready to... attack. Once you give them a passage. Like, there's 12,000 CSA soldiers. These three brigades will clean up the house over there. Along with these two. The rest of them? Keep advancing over here. Get stuck in, right? Okay, most of the Confederate forces on the field here have been routed or broken. I think I've dealt with half their army. How much have I lost of mine? I still have 40,000 troops, 53,000. But I did throw in 80,000 troops in total, so this is only a portion of my army. These two... Sherman will go ahead. I'll take Rosencrantz. Keep him there as well. I need to deal with this damn artillery. The fort must be held until nightfall. Well, we have it, just we need to hold it. Reinforcements, huh? A division? No, divisions. It doesn't matter. We do have the fort. So frankly, it does not matter one damn bit. Okay. Well, 21,000 men left. We need to take the city. So we have these points. Now come the defensive works of Richmond. Star forts. Oof. That's quite something. Quite something. That is formidable. Well, we outnumbered them 3-1, so that's gotta count for something, I imagine. It's not like they have better troops or better weapons. They don't. We have better weapons, better troops overall, and 3-1 advantage. Alright. Let this begin. Casualties have been heavy, haven't they? I've lost so many good soldiers, so many good brigades really are on the brink. My artillery is relatively unscathed. That might be a problem, but... And is there any point where I can attack without losing fuck ton of units? I'm guessing these woods over here. Probably. Maybe. Potentially. So this side. Though they do obviously. No, they don't have units there. Go! Go, 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 go. Alright, we need to capture the North Fort. They don't have enough troops to properly man any of these positions, do they? Actually, this is about half their force, isn't it? In total. Right, we'll take that fort. Oh, so the real difficult battle was in the trenches, wasn't it? Take those trenches, win the war. There were a lot of Union soldiers that died in those trenches in the actual war, though. Thank you. Alright, concentrate on the attack from the east. New brigades. No issue. This, however, will be. So the North Fort will go down. Another. Alright, those units over there should probably be enough. I'm gonna take all of these brigades and I'm gonna concentrate them over here. Meanwhile, the brigades over here. Okay, the Star Fort is probably going to be the most formidable challenge of all of them. I'm going to lose a lot of men trying to take it. I don't need the... How many men do they have left? 5,000. Less. Let's get to it then. I'll leave some men here. These brigades, they've done enough, right? Okay, we've captured the center fort, now just the star fort, the most difficult of all of them. Move everything we have against it. This breaks. The city is ours. Ah, this attack from the south. Good. We do have to take these positions, though. Well, they may have quite a few more troops left. 5,000 troops. But their problem is they don't have enough to stop me on any level. Maybe there's a few brigades here and there, but there's obviously going to be about 2,000 soldiers in the fort. So about half their army is in that fort. Or so. Maybe, yeah, maybe exaggeration, but still. People get the idea. I mean, hell, there's no one here. What? Kidding me? I didn't expect to just take Richmond. There we go. Some defenders. But yes, as expected, most of their men are concentrated at that fort. And that's meaningless because that fort is not gonna protect them from this attack. Okay. What do we have here exactly? Oh, damn it. So be it then. Full on assault. I'll leave a couple of units. Weaker ones. To hold the line against the Confederate cavalry, but the majority of my army will have to take that fort. Damn the cost, right? It will cost what it will cost. So said the Prussian general when he charged with his cavalry against an entrenched French position during the Franco-Prussian War. It will cost what it will cost. They're not really holding on there. It's now or never. I'll send the cavalry in. Alright, we've held. Battle is won, the war is won. Quite the bloodbath, but it is a victory. May have lost half my army. That's a bit expected, considering how heavy the defenses were. Could have done better, more patience and all that, but... that's another thing about this game. Rushing works. In fact, it's mandatory pretty much. Sending over there. Drive the last Confederates off the field. Well, we lost 30,000 men. They lost 40,000 men. They lost 213 guns, 2,000 cavalry, 2,000 missing. Excellent. Lost several officers, several wounded. Not too bad concerning everything. Got some Tyler, Texases, some Harper's Ferry, some supplies. Quite a lot of supplies, even. Alright. Well, we killed 3 times as many cavalry, well, almost 3 times as many cavalry, 4 times, 5 times as many artillery units, and 2 times as many infantry. We captured 9,300 soldiers, could have been better. In the war between the states, your leadership and skill became a matter of national pride. Your men would follow you anywhere, and you returned home a hero greeted with parades and great fanfare. The people of the great state of New York elected you governor by an overwhelming margin. Your skill at managing an army in the field will prove invaluable for managing an entire state. The Union has finally prevailed. A grand victory. The Medal of Honor, the Distinguished Service Cross, the Meritus Service Cross, the Defense Superior Service Medal, the Union Officer Medal, the Union Protector Star, the War Service Medal, and the Civil War Campaign Medal. Well, that was a victory as the Union. It's certainly quite something, isn't it? Some of those battles, Chickamauga, Shiloh, you know, some of those, they can be quite a Chancellorsville. They can be quite annoying. Anyway. Hope you all enjoyed this. Costin signing out. And if you like my content, do consider supporting me via PayPal or